Hi, I'm Greg Perkins with Oak Ridge Bellows, and today we're talking about why an expansion joint works, and specifically, how does it handle pressure? How does such a thin member like a bellows, and it is a thin member, let's look at one real quick. This is thin, compared to a piece of pipe. How does such a thin member like this get even close to being able to handle the types of pressure that a much thicker pipe would be able to handle? Well, you know what? I'm not going to leave you on the edge of your seats. Because we all have short attention spans. You could click out of this video at any moment. So hang with me. It's all about being able to get lots of material crammed within a certain length and be able to up our cross-sectional area. Okay, so now you know, and maybe you'll hang with me and we'll talk about that in a little bit more detail. Let's talk about how a pipe handles pressure. And then we'll go right back to that cross-sectional area that I just showed you. A pipe, and I'm gonna draw a cross-section of a pipe, and we're gonna look at how pressures and stresses work on that pipe. Hang with me here. You'll be well rewarded. Well, I say that. You might be bored to tears. Okay, so that is my cross-section of my pipe right there. And the pressure is trying to pull that apart. And so we have what we call a stress. We're talking hoop stress here. You may have heard that phrase. It's trying to pull this cylinder apart, any cylinder. And for the inside pressure, then we have this distributed pressure clear across the diameter. We're going to call that P, and we're going to write our D in here. Let's not forget where that D is. And we have some other important dimensions here, the pipe wall thickness, T. And then we're going to say, okay, we've got a unit length, L. We're going to find out that unit length, L, is not as important as we may think it is, but we're going to keep making reference to it. Okay, so, this is a free body diagram right here, and it's statics. And if we're doing statics, then we know everything should equal zero if nothing's moving. So let's try that. One side is pushing, one side's pulling. We've got sigma, and we got two of those. And we have the cross-sectional area, T, times unit length, L. That's all what's acting on one side, all right? And it's going to be countered by the internal pressure of the pipe over here. So let's do that. Let's say then we've got P, and we're acting across this area, and this area is going to be D times L. Okay, now you're looking at the equation, you're going, hey, I got L's on each side, so that means I can legally do that. I can just pitch those L's. That's why those L's really don't mean anything, and I'm going to set everything equal to my hoop stress. And then it's all going to make sense here. We've got PD over 2T. You recognize that. That's the old classical hoop stress equation. The more you have down here in the denominator, then the lower the stresses get on this. And conversely, if you swapped out, if we were solving for pressure, then we'd find out that the more area we've got here, this cross-sectional area, the more more pressure that pipe's able to hold. Okay, you remember my opening statement about getting all that material, that convoluted material, all within a unit length L. Well, that's exactly what a bellows does, and in kind of a point of our topic. I'm gonna go blue because it just really, you know, adds to the whole experience here. Yeah, here's my cross-sectional area, and let's just say that's gonna be the same L that we had over there. Well, you can see that, yeah, even though that's thin right there, I got a bunch of it in there. And so the more area that I can get in there, and that acts right there on that denominator, the more area that I got on there, the more it's able to hold pressure and weight. I'm not through. If we want to get higher pressures, what we do is we form these things with reinforcing rings. Well, if it's a circle like that, we call those root rings. And then that even makes this denominator even bigger, that section right there. We could even add what we call equalizing rings right here T-rings, and that allows us to even throw more area in there and be able to get higher pressure. Sure, there's other things going on here, sidewall bending and things like that, but that's the fundamentals. It's hoop stress. Now, you may have seen an equation somewhere, and that somewhere would have been the expansion joint manufacturer's equation for the hoop stress on a bellows, and it's big, it's hairy, it's complicated looking. I got one right here. Hang on, let me get one. All right, here it is, and let's get a close-up of this. Look, these are all hoop stress equations, what we call S1 and S2. And they're kind of complicated looking. Well, you know what? Let me debunk that complication right there. We saw what we did here. If you were just to take all this cross-sectional area and you were to throw in all the variables for these little semicircles and half circles and straight walls, then you would come up and you put it in there, then yes, you'd come up with this large, hairy-looking equation. But we're not going to be intimidated by that equation because it's just the hoop stress. That's how a bellows is able to take pressure. I know you're sitting on the edge of your seat saying, okay, tell me about part two. Tell me about how it flexes and what's going on there. No, not going to do it. Well, I am going to do it. We're up against a hard break right now. You can join us at www.oakridgebellows.com and you can find out that part two. Because I know I got you sitting on the edge of your seats.